everyone. I'm coming to you live from Sun Hill Road in Penn Township, and you can see behind me why another covered bridge here has been hit. We just covered another one a couple weeks ago in East Hempfield Township that had been hit twice in the same week, and now here we go again with a truck that is just too large. The police here say that that truck was 2 tons above the weight limit and obviously higher than the 10'6" allowance here for height, and that driver just kept going through. Let me turn the camera around here. You can see kind of the scene here where the police are parked here. They do plan to cite the driver of this truck that went through the covered bridge. I know it's loud here because the tow truck driver is here to pull this truck out very carefully, obviously. Hope it's not caused any further damage to this bridge. The Burke's food truck went through just around 11 o'clock this morning. There's what's called a headache bar, and if you look just under where the clearance sign is at the top of that covered bridge, there is a little bar that hangs down so that if a truck that is too tall happens to go through, they hope that it would hit that and hear that noise, realize that it's too tall to go under this bridge and stop. Obviously, that is not what this driver did. Police say the driver hit that and then kept going and took out about 10 blanks in before actually stopping. You can see it appears they even ripped the top off the truck there, some pieces hanging down. Bob is asking if they're going to make the driver pay for the damage. That is the case. Police say not only will this driver be heavily cited for this, but also they will go after his insurance company to pay for the damage. Interestingly enough, this bridge just about a year ago got a brand new roof because someone else had hit it. This seems to be a common occurrence in Lancaster County with truck drivers that are just too tall or too heavy going through, not paying enough attention. They said they interviewed the driver and he just said he thought that he was under that 10'6" clearance. Obviously, that is not the case. So now the tow truck drivers are trying to hook up that truck and pull it out. They have pulled it out. When this actually happened, the truck was all the way through in the middle of that bridge, but now it has been obviously pulled out a little bit. So I'll try to take you a little bit closer here. Hopefully you'll still be able to hear me. The driver was on scene a little bit ago, but I think he's on the other side of the bridge now. So we weren't able to get a chance to talk to him, but look here, you can see some of the damage, some of the boards from the bridge there. This is a part of Lancaster County history. Many of these bridges have been here for so long, and it's so sad when they get hit like this and damaged because they are Lancaster County treasures. I believe there is a sign about the bridge up here. I obviously don't want to get in the way of the tow truck drivers, but I was hoping to learn some more about this particular bridge. One of the police officers here on scene said he thought it was the Kaufman Bridge, but I don't see a sign for that just yet. It could be on the other side of this tow truck right here. But right now they are working on getting that truck hooked up and very carefully pulling it out, because if I can take you up here, it looks like they're not moving just yet. You can see where it's wedged in underneath the roof there, and looking through the bridge here, it's pretty dark, but you can see there's still crews inside the bridge checking on the stability of it to make sure that once they do take this truck out, will it still be able to stand. This road is closed right now to traffic. So this is 800 West Sun Hill Road in Penn Township. Someone's mentioning to let the air out of the tires. I don't know if the tow truck company is actually doing that or what their plan is. But there's some more close-up damage of the truck there. The top of it, you can see what happened. Let's see if I can sneak over here without getting in anyone's way and just show you the work that the tow truck, it does look. Are you letting the air out of the tires?
Actually putting it back in right now.
We're on Facebook Live. Do you mind telling us what you're doing?
So basically we pulled the truck out of the bridge. We left the air out of the tires so we could lower it to pull it out of the bridge, dump the rear suspension. And so now we got the back end out. We're going to air up the rear tires and pull it out the rest of the way to air up the front tires. So.
What kind of a delicate process is this to make sure you don't do any more damage?
Well, I think the damage was already done prior to us getting here.
Yeah.
So, I mean, at this point, they removed a couple braces in the bridge, so we didn't do more damage when we winched it backwards. So, yeah, I mean, the damage was done prior to us getting here. So.
Is this something you see all too often?
Not a lot. Every once in a great while, but, yeah, not a lot.
All right. Maybe not your particular company, but here in Lancaster County, throughout the county, I know we've been seeing it more often than you likely should, at least. And what is your reaction when you see a historic bridge like this hit?
Well, yeah, I mean, I always fear about the weight that's in the truck because these bridges are only rated for so much weight. So, I mean, this truck is loaded. So, fortunately, it didn't do any damage as far as the weight is concerned. It's just done some damage to the roof of the bridge and the roof of the truck. But, yeah, I mean, at this point, I'd say that the damage to the bridge is minor. So
they said that the truck was 2 tons heavier than it should be for this bridge. It's a refrigerated truck, is that right?
Yeah, it's a reefer truck. Yeah, it's, yes. And it is loaded with meat, yeah.
Yeah, so that's definitely way too heavy to go across these old wooden boards.
Absolutely, yeah.
All right. Thanks for your time. Keep your hard work up here. I know people are hoping that this bridge will be open and repaired soon, so we're going to let them do their job here and back out of the way.